to make your Facebook account completely private. Now, there are many ways that need to be implemented in order to do this. So I highly recommend that if you do want to hide your make your profile completely private, that you watch until the end of this video. If you only implement, the first few ways, then you'll make it a little bit more private, but it will not be completely private. So just a recommendation in case you want to get the most out of making it private absolutely completely. Now, there's quite a few areas to get to, so let's jump right into it. The first one here is you're going to click on the top right lockbox, and first go down to who can see my stuff. So who can see my future posts? I already have this set to only me, but you can set this to, I mean, you want to set this to only me if you want to be private. If you have it on public, just make sure to switch it there. Now, as you'll see as we go along, there are many different areas here. So, you might want to implement them all to make it as private as possible, but you might only want to do 80 or 90% of them. There might be some areas here that, you're okay with leaving. But I'm just trying to show you if you want to make it as private as possible with the features that Facebook makes available, just follow these steps. So the next one is who can contact me? Whose messages don't want filtered in my inbox? You can leave it at basic, but if you really, again, if you just want to do it as private as possible, click on strict filtering. Who can send me friend requests? Now, unfortunately, Facebook, they give you only the option here of everyone and friends of friends. So with that one, for whatever reasons, not switching for me right now. But for you, if you click on friends of friends, after you click it should be showing up here. So make sure to show that. So, it's not that no one will be able to send you friend requests, but it makes it more private to as much as possible as Facebook actually lets you to have just your friends of friends as opposed to everyone. So that's just a step you can take. I saw someone bothering me. If I mean, this is just separate, but if you do have, someone specific that has been bothering you, you can just put in their name or email here, and you can just block them completely. But that's a different topic for a different video. If you click on See More Settings, next step. If you do want to learn how to block, I have made a video about it before, so you can just check my channel out. So you're gonna be dropped off on this privacy page now. Who can see your future posts? So again, I have this already set to only me, but if you have this on public, make sure to click the edit box and go down to only me. Close this because that was already on only me. Okay, now the next one is you can skip the review all your posts, but if you go to limit the audience for posts you've shared with friends of friends or public, so click on limit past posts. If you do want to, limit your old posts to actually show up on your timeline, so you just click on limit old posts, click confirm, and now it says the audience for the selected content has been changed. Close. I'm going to close that. Who can send you friend requests? So, yeah, that is what we actually were doing right there. So here it seems to be working. So you can do it from either area. And as you saw with me, if it doesn't work in one area, it seems that it's going to work in another. Whose messages do I want filtered into my inbox? This is pretty much the same thing as we just saw up there. And it already took that setting from up there. So that one worked. Who can look me up? So it separates this into email address and phone number. Now, the first one is it asks you who can look you up using the email address you provided. So the most private setting you can do here is friends itself. There isn't an only me option, so you just gotta click friends there. And the exact same thing for the phone number. I mean, your friends technically, they should be able to look you up. So it does make sense that they can do that. But for anyone else, you can limit that, so it's only your friends. Do you want other search engines to link to your timeline? This is already set to to no. But if you had that on yes, just make sure to click that, this little box here, which will be the opposite. It'll say, you know, don't let search engines look at your timeline. Click that and then click OK after. This should show no after. Okay, moving forward to timeline and tagging. So who can post in your timeline? Again, if you want to make this private possible, open that up, click only me. Review post friends tag you in before they appear on your timeline. Now, if someone tags you, you know, automatically, usually it'll just show the picture with your tag in there and you have no say about it. You can go and edit thereafter, but you know, it might be a few hours till you ever even find out about it. So if you want it to be hidden from the timeline until you yourself enable it, so this is already set to that. If this was on disabled, come in here, switch that to enabled. Who can see things on my timeline? So we're gonna skip the first one for a second. We'll come back to that at the end. Who can see posts you've been tagged in on your timeline? Again, another one, click it, only me. If it hasn't been set on only me already, same thing for who can see what others post in your timeline. Exact same thing. Make sure it's that one's on only me. Now, this is similar to up here, just the wording's a little bit different, but this is review posts friends tag you in. This one is review tags people add you to your own post. So, you know, slightly different, but just, again, just make sure that that's set to enabled. When you're tagging posts, do you want to add the audience if they aren't already in it? Again, make that one only me. And now we're all done with this section. We are going to move forward to followers. Now, this one's really simple. Who can follow me? Followers see your post in newsfeed, gives you a little blurb here. But if you only want to set the follow function to the most private as possible, then the most private as possible Facebook lets you get here, again, is just friends. So make sure that one's set to friends. Now we're going to move forward. So you're going to go back to your profile and you're going to first click on About. Now in the About section, you're going to find it's now called Contact and Basic Info. So click on that. And so your email, mine's already hidden from the timeline, but if your email isn't hidden, just click on edit here and just make sure to hide it. Going down to birth date here. So this is just, you know, test account, just to, you know, show these tutorials. So there's not that much information here, but you know, you might have 7, 8, 10 fields here filled out. So it's the exact same process for all of them. But what you do there is, as you can see here, so right now my birthday is set to show to friends. Now it separates into two little boxes here, because one is actually for your month and day of birth, and the other one's for your year. So you can choose to, you know, show how they're going to show separately each one. So if you want to make them both completely private, make sure, again, just as before, go down to only me and then go to save changes. And as I was saying, you know, you can do the same thing for any other ones you've filled out here. Just make sure to click the edit box and you'll see here, or you can even click that lock box right next to the edit, because the lock box will show you what the current setting is. And if you click that, you can edit it right away. So a couple different ways of doing that. So now we're going to go back to the profile and we're going to go to friends section. So now friends, what we're actually going to do is we're going to hide your friends list so that people can't see it. So you're going to click on manage and we're going to edit privacy. And this will pop up. Now the first one, I actually just did a video recently specifically about this, but it's very much a part of making your account completely private. So it's very important that you take this step as well. Who can see your friend list? So if that's not set to only me, open that, click only me. And who can see the people in the list that you follow? Same thing. If it's not set to only me, make that only me. And once you're done, click done. Now, moving forward to photos. So what we're gonna do here actually is you can make each one of your photos private. Now, the way to do that is I'm actually gonna click on this. There's a little arrow dropdown with a couple of icons of people, an icon of a couple of people right there. So this one layout's a little bit different. They show public and friends, but they give you the option to open for more. Now, if it's only that you, if you're the only one that wants to be able to see this, then you'll just click on only me. And that's it, escape to close. You can also do this for your profile picture, especially if you, again, want to make it as private as possible. Now, this was actually the profile picture for this account that I made private before. This is already on only me. But if you want to do this for your own profile picture, you know, same process, and same thing for your cover photo, if you have one. And now, if you've taken all those steps, your Facebook profile is going to be as private as it can possibly get right now under the current Facebook settings. If you want to actually see what it looks like to the public, for instance, so you just click these three buttons here and go to view as. And this tool lets you see what your timeline looks like to the public or a specific friend. So right now this is just to public, and you know, as you can see here, it's very, very as minimal amount of as information as possible. And whereas before, obviously, there was a whole bunch of other information that was showing here publicly. And that's how to make your Facebook profile completely private. If this helped you, please give it a like. Let me know by commenting below. Don't forget to subscribe to the Techoist YouTube channel and check out techoist.com for more great tips. Thanks.